are the three tips that I want to give you for today, right? How do you master the fundamentals of coding? Before making any important, significant decision of your life, first ask yourself, why are you taking that decision?
Hello guys, good evening. Is my voice audible? Because I'm facing some issue with the mic as well as with the net. So if you can let me know in the chat box.
Yes, you are audible.
Okay, thank you, Sumit. I don't know what is happening from my side. So guys, good evening. I hope all of you have a must have a great day. And I'm here to close this evening on a positive and productive note. So I welcome all of you to this India's first late night Saturday tech webinar brought to you by MFL Edu Club every Saturday night at 11 with Pramit Bhuyan. So I think, guys, you will be excited for today's session because we are going to discuss regarding a very important topic among students, which you can see I have already shared on the screen. So if you guys are really excited for today's session, keep hitting the chat box with word excited.
Hey everybody, how are you guys doing? Awesome. Good evening everybody, good to meet you all. So it's 11. We'll wait for a couple of more minutes. Good evening, Sumit. Awesome. So I will share my screen in the meanwhile. Awesome. So I hope my screen is visible to all of you. So guys, we'll begin in exactly 2 minutes from now. Let's give some time for more folks to join in. In the meanwhile, what we should do is take some time to introduce ourselves like we typically do. If some of you who are joining us back from previous sessions, that's what we customarily do, right? So let's go ahead and introduce ourselves, guys. Just our name and place where we are from. Good evening, Sumit, Seema, Saurav. Thank you, Sumit. Good evening. Good evening, Kartikeya. Good to have you in the session again. Awesome, guys. Let's go ahead and introduce ourselves in the chat section. Just our names and where we are from. Welcome, Saurav. Welcome, Pratishruti. Regular faces in our sessions. Good to have you guys back. Good evening, Sumit, again. I think after a while, right? So yeah, tempo high rahega. And yeah, so guys who've joined now, let's introduce ourselves in the chat box. Just our name and where we're from. We'll begin in a couple of minutes. Welcome, Shrikaran. Good to have you. Okay. So while we're waiting for maybe a few more folks to join in, I'll quickly introduce myself. And from there, we will go on to our session. Okay. So this is Pramit. I'm a software architect currently with Amazon, working in the fintech team. And before that, for 10 years, I was with Microsoft, various teams in Azure team, in VSTS, Windows, and CRM teams. I think that was, and I'm very passionate about mentoring students. And I keep mentoring students, I keep hosting webinars, and I have hosted many of them. This series, Saturday Night Gyan, right, is is a series that I had on my mind for a while. And in this series, we hosted 10 webinars where I talked about different things that I had on my mind, which is all the recordings of all the sessions are hosted in the YouTube channel of MFL Edu Club. If you have not been able to attend any of these sessions, definitely feel free to attend, go and browse through the recordings. Last session, we had a session around the basics of cloud, right? We actually logged in into Azure and AWS interfaces and looked at various solutions that are available in cloud, compute solutions, networking solutions, storage solutions, and understood the very basics of those solutions, right? And then again, we discussed very briefly what is serverless computing.
Right?
What is Lambda? What is Azure Functions? What is Docker? Docker containers, right? So we discussed a little bit of that at a very overview level. So if you missed last session, or if you want to recap, revise, I have pasted the YouTube link of that, the recording of that session, which I guess went live a few couple of days back or so. So feel free to go back and revise there, right? So there you'll get a look and feel of what the actual Azure or AWS interface looks like. What are the things that you can do for free? What are the things that you can do by paying a little bit? Okay, cool. So today's session is a very important session, and hopefully you will all learn something from today's session, right? In my opinion, very important session. And the problem is this, that Indian students, like myself when I was in college, we did not have a financial plan. And what was our plan? Effectively, the plan was get as high a package as possible, go enjoy life, and that's it. Right? That is pretty much if I were to summarize my plan when I was a student. And what was the result? Like, if I had not got a good placement, fortunately I did, but if I had not got a good placement, or if I had not got any placement at all, because my year, right, when I passed there, that year also there was a recession going on. So companies were not hiring. So I remember when Microsoft came to our campus, they hired 3 folks. Yahoo hired like 1 person or something. Amazon did not hire anybody. Google did not even come. So it was a recession year. So, and I can totally imagine, I totally remember the fear that I had back then, right? Like, what would happen if I don't get placed? What is my plan? So basically I had no plan, and that is not how at all it should be. And people should not be scared of not getting placed. People should not be scared of going and creating their own startups with their own financial plans with no effective income of their own, right? So these are actually not really scary situations at all. And that is what we want to analyze today. We want to think a little bit. If many of you actually might have, which is good, but many of you might not have thought through, right? So what we will do is we will have a brief discussion, and we will try to create a very first version of a financial plan for you. We will actually try that, right? And at the end of it, last 5 to 10 minutes, I want to give some good tips from my experience. I don't claim that I have had like a very long experience in my life, but I have still had significant experience, right? About financials, how scared you should be, what are the good things and bad things that are going to happen in your life when you are going into your actual profession, right? So there are some things I will talk to you about from my experience. That's the end. And at the end, I hope that you will all learn something from today's session, and which will contribute to you getting braver and taking bigger risks in life, and also learning something from my experience. Let's see. Okay, so before we move on with today's agenda, a quick question to all of you. Feel free to answer in the chat box. What are the characteristics of a good financial plan. Because today, let's say we are going to make a financial plan for you. So what are the good, what are characteristics of a good financial plan? Please respond in the chat box. What do you guys think? So let's say we make a financial plan. What plan will you qualify as good? Come on, guys. What are some properties of a good financial plan? Backup for 6 months at least. Good. Okay. Good. Any of you invest in stocks or stock market? I guess not, but few of you maybe. Pratishwiti is saying we should take care of economy. Okay. Okay. Darshan is saying better knowledge in financial system. Okay, definitely important. Better knowledge of finances and financial system. But the plan that you're making today, right? What are, how will you qualify? How will you judge it? Is it a good plan, bad plan? Shrikaran is saying to look forward. We need perfectionist plan. Okay. Saurav is saying not too much afraid of market situation. Very good point. See, Saurav is bringing in a very, very good point, right? So the plan should be such that you don't, you're not afraid of market situations, because market will go up and down. Your plan should be so that it handles both the situations, right? Very good point. Any other point? What qualifies a good plan? Advice from an experienced person. Another very important point, Shrikaran is saying, right? So the plan, I will interpret it as this. In fact, I also had that on my mind. The plan should not be theoretical, right? The plan should be a realistic plan which draws from real experiences of people. So reach out to your parents, reach out to any relative who has had his own business experience, reach out to a professional who has had 15, 20, 25, 30, right? Like you reached out to me. I should reach out to a person who's about to retire maybe, or who's 10 years older than me, to get to understand their financial plans, right? And learn from that. So learn from real data points. Don't learn from theory, right? Another important point. Good, Shikaran. So two things that we have been noting till now. Our plan should plan for best case as well as worst case, because it will happen throughout your lifetime. Sometime it will definitely happen, right? Unless you are in a government job. In fact, I think in government job also it will happen, the way Air India and Indian Railways and everything is going, all the banks, right? So they are being merged, and slowly they'll be all be privatized. I'm sure of that. So you need to plan for best case as well as worst case, because market situations will change. The second is, learn from real data points and not for just from theory. Okay. And another plan, I think Shrikaran said previously, and also I think a few others, I think Pratishruti also, that it should never fail. I mean, if you are creating a plan that does not cover all the scenarios, then it might fail. So try to make it a fail-proof plan, right? Awesome. So what we will do next, because I don't want to create a plan for you, you will, right? But what I will do is help you by asking you some tough questions, right? So what I'll do is ask you some tough questions, calling out that these are personal questions, don't mind, right? So let's, in the spirit of creating a financial plan for all of you, today's aim is to create a solid financial plan for all of you, right? Well, that's the goal for today. So I'll ask you some tough questions. My request is this, that when I ask you the question, I want you to note down the question itself in your notebook, in your phone, wherever you are, right? Note down the question and also note down your answer. And at the end of this session, you will have a good set of questions and answer. And that will be the first version of your financial plan. Okay. Does that sound like a plan, guys? Yes, no? a game that we will play. Awesome. And don't paste your answer immediately in the chat box. I'll give you some time. After maybe around 30 seconds, if you want, you can paste your answer in the chat box. And don't be shy at all, right? Because pretty much we are almost anonymous here. So, and nobody is going to remember your answer 30 minutes after the session. So don't be shy. So I'll ask you tough questions. I'm already telling you personal questions. You need to think hard, right? You need to project into the future. Think hard and try to give as realistic answer as possible, right? And that is important for us to come up with a good plan for ourselves, right? Each one to their own. Don't be biased by others' answers, right? And others' answers doesn't even matter to our answers. We should only be worried about our own answers, right? Awesome. Okay, so first question. How much money do you want from your first job? Please note down the question as well as your answer and don't put it on the chat box yet. So there are a bunch of such questions that force you to think about your future. How much money do you want from your first job? No range, one specific answer. In fact, let me imagine that I am a student back like 12 years ago and I'll also answer all the questions. Let's see, the right answer. So note down the question, that's my request, so that you have a financial plan and the answer also, okay? So I'm assuming most of you are still in college. Some of you might have passed out, that's also fine. You can retrospectively answer, that's why. Like me. So guys, do all of us have some sort of answer? Okay, Satya Prakash, hold on. Don't paste it in the chat box yet. We will all paste it together. And good question, by the way, Satya Prakash, let's not go per month, maybe per annum. A very ballpark number, right? Doesn't matter. Satya Prakash is like 48,000. He's like very clear. Good. Welcome, Satya Prakash. I think you joined a little bit late. That's okay. So how much money do you want from your first job? Right? Now let's write it. I'm writing what I probably thought when I was a student. But feel free to write your number. Thank you, Kuldeep. No shame. Nobody's going to remember your number 30 minutes from now, right? Satyajit, thank you. Sumit, thank you. Saurav, thank you. Keep writing, right? Keep writing your number. Nobody's going to remember 20 seconds from now, your number. But it is what? By writing, you're cementing your number, right? Thank you, Shaheen. Thank you, Darshan. Write your realistic number, right? If it is 5 LPA, write 5 LPA. Let's say my CG is 5, right? If it is 0 LPA, by the way, write 0 LPA, no problem. But write your, it is important that you write a realistic number so that you, because it doesn't, actually it doesn't matter. Some people might have 0 also, because if I want plan to start a startup, it could be 0 as well, right? Because it is startup. In fact, I am looking for investment. So it could be 0. So it's 0 is also okay. It's not at all bad. But you need to have some number there so that you can plan for future, project into future, right? Awesome. So thank you, Sanaya. Thank you, Satya Prakash. Thank you, Pratishruti. Thank you, Gaurav. Thank you, Ayush. Awesome. Awesome. So we have some number with us. Okay. Next question. What will you do with that money if you get it? Assuming you'll get exactly that amount, what will you do with that money? Shaheen is saying save most of it. Okay. By the way, guys, note down this question in your notebook, phone, wherever, because you will have a bunch of 10 to 12 questions and that will be your version one financial plan. You need to go and expand on it much, much more. You need to think deeply, right? But note down the questions as well as your current answers. They will change Don't bother about it. They will change. But let's note down our questions and answers. So we'll give 10-15 seconds. Then let's start writing down on the chat box. What do you think you will do with that money? When I was a student, I did not have any plan. I just had a plan that I'll get some money and maybe I'll just enjoy it, right? But let's think hard. What will you actually do with that money? Sumit is saying, okay, I'll hold my thoughts for 10-15 seconds. Lots of good answers. I'll read them all out. People have thought, right? Okay, so let's read through somebody's people's answers. But guys, keep putting your answers. What I'm trying to do is trying to force you to think, right? Okay, let's read. Shaheen, save most of it. Good. But in the last part, right, I have some tips for you, right? So I'll share at least my tips. Feel free to disagree or agree. Sumit is saying, buy lots of books. I want to read. Books are, Sumit, actually very inexpensive. Quick tip, you need to plan, invest. Also, you're saying, good. Satya Prakash is saying, invest in my personal initiative. Good. I'm assuming you have a personal initiative, Satya Prakash. Ayush is saying, spend for further growth. Yeah, Ayush, I know, is a very shrewd investor. So no doubt about that. Gaurav is saying, invest 30% of it in mutual fund. Very good. So that's a concrete plan. Very good. Right? Shrikaran is saying, enjoy. Yeah, Shrikaran, probably the same answer that I would have given when I was in your place. But you need a better plan. And I'll give you the tip exactly what I think you guys should do. Right? At the end. Sumit is again saying, expend in bodybuilding diet. Awesome. Traveling. Awesome. Sumit, I have important tip for you. Remember your answer, right? And in fact, encourage all of you to write down your answer. Current answer. It is important, right? And you can write down the revisions of your answer later on as well. Saurabh is saying 60% invest, 30% spending, 10% charity. Wow. I think this is super awesome answer. I think at least he is trying to think through, right? Think deep. So totally appreciate it. Totally appreciate it. I think it's a very good plan as well. In fact, my tip is probably aligning very much with that. Darshan, 30% save, 50% investment, 20% donation. Awesome. Shaheen is saying, okay, good, appreciate it. Pratishruti is saying saving, fulfilled desire, donation. Very good. Shaheen is saying 10% to charity. Okay. See, he or she is inspired, which is good. Awesome. Kuldeep is saying, I'll definitely spend on my personal growth and invest in some stocks. Awesome. Kuldeep, thank you. Even I would do that, I guess. What better way to spend money? Awesome. Sorry, thanks. Okay. Sanaya is saying, help poor ones. Okay. Appreciate it, Sanaya. Satyajit is saying savings for a business startup. Okay. Sanaya Singh, travel different countries. Awesome. She can actually produce a film. Awesome. So I think, see, produce a film, he has like thought very deep, which is also awesome. Moving to next question, right? We'll come back to all these questions in the last part. What are my tips? But each to your own answer, right? I think people getting inspired from each other, which is also awesome. What will you do if you don't get as much money as you thought? Take some time, 10-15 seconds, and then let's start putting our answers in the chat box. What will you do if you don't get as much money as you thought? Okay, I think we can start putting our answers in the chat box. Okay, I'll show the next question also. You can club them together. What will you do if you don't get any money in the first year after college? I'm clubbing the questions together, but in your notebook, if you're noting down, or in your phone, anywhere, right? Note both the questions differently, because it's slightly different to get somewhat less money, and it is also a completely different scenario to not get any money. So I'm forcing you to think about the worst case, which we actually, most of us don't think. We simply assume that we will get some money, right? So what will you do if you don't get, if you get lesser money? What will you do if you don't get any money in the first year? Like, let's say somebody, some student got paralysis, or some student got rusticated from college for whatever reason. Some student couldn't pass college, right? All possible scenarios. Some forcing. Some student got fired from their job. Some student got did not get the, they got the offer, but they did not get the actual joining date, right? All possible scenarios. So what will you do if you get lesser money? One, what will you do if you don't get any money? Possible for everybody. Don't assume you're above it. And you will, we will also see that I'll ask the same question in future also. Maybe after college you will get, right? Possibly. But it, this scenario might happen after 10 years. So you, this question will still be very, very relevant. So think deep and hard and see what answer you come up with. Okay. I'm reading through the answers now. Darshan is saying, I'll make other source of income. Darshan, important point. Very, very good and very, very important point. See, immediately as you pass, right, you may not be able to make other source of income. We recognize that fact. But as you gradually get some income, it is very important to diversify, as in to make some other source of income. It is very, very important. I can't emphasize on this more, right? So you need to, all of you need to do that. So in, as part of your financial plan, it is very important to not lose focus on this aspect, right? Shrikaran is saying, and think to get a loan to, for to do my capability work to get well enough money what I need. Shrikaran, loan, but from whom? You can go get a loan from bank, but bank will likely not even give you a loan if you don't have a steady income already, one. But then think about different channels. Maybe you can get a loan from your parents in the beginning, right? This is your worst case plan we're talking about. Worst case plan. And how much loan do you need? We will come to that question. That question is there in future. How much loan do you need in the worst case scenario, right? Should you ask for 10 lakhs loan? Should you ask for 2 lakhs loan, right? We will think, plan for your exact worst case scenario. Okay, but a good point, important, that you might have to take a loan. So who will you take a loan from? If your parents are very poor, then you can't take a loan from your parents. Maybe some relative is rich. So maybe you need to plan out that I'll need to have a good relation with that relative, maybe help them out in their business or do whatever, so that in my worst case, I'll get the amount of loan. Maybe it is 2 lakhs. I'll get a loan of 2 lakhs for the first 2 years, right? So you need to plan for that worst case. And it is important. Don't plan just for average or best case, right? Okay. Ayush is saying, start thinking of taking further risk accordingly. Okay, Ayush, keep taking risks. But you still need something, right? Forget about risks. What will you eat? Worst case we're talking about, right? So you need to plan for that. Okay, Kartikeya is saying, I will think something is better than nothing, be happy and look for other sources of earn more. Yes, Kartikeya, good point, but you need to plan for it. What is that other source of income? You need to plan for it now, right? You need to maybe prepare your parents also, that if in the worst case, something happens in the next 2 to 3 years, or I plan out for a startup, so I will not have an income, right? The PC funding that I'll get will enable me for something, for my business, but maybe I'll income, I'll still need 15K per month from you. That's your worst case contingency loan plan from your parents. Possible, right? Or maybe from your friend or from anybody. I don't know who that is for you, but you need to plan for that worst case. Okay, good. Kartikeya. Thank you. Kuldeep is saying, wow, this is something what I'm facing right now. Awesome. Awesome, Kuldeep. But you need to think a little bit long term for that. And also not just now, it might happen again in a very, what should I say, in a much worse future. Because if, right now I'm hoping you don't have any liabilities, right? In future, when you have liabilities, when you are married or when you have kids, when you have parents who are very old, in that scenario, right, it might be much worse. So you still need to plan much better for that scenario. We'll actually come to that in a subsequent question. Pratishwiti is saying, I'll work hard to get more money. I'll do some part-time job. Yes, Pratishwiti, that part-time job that you're talking about, right, is your alternate plan. So what part-time will you do? What are your capabilities? You need to plan now. I can maybe part-time do teaching. Maybe I can do part-time, I don't know, something, marketing, right? Or some social, I don't know, whatever. But you need to plan it now. Now's the time. So we don't, because we think that it will never happen to us, right? Let's not assume that. Shine is saying, maybe use the time to learn skills that I'm lacking. It's also a good point. Good point. I had not thought of it. Shine, good point. That maybe use that time to learn the skills. But then Shine, also think about, how will you manage yourself? Who will give you food, right? You need some income. So let's plan for that. Gaurav is saying, upgrade my skills. Definitely. I think that aligns with what Shine said. But Gaurav, you still need to plan for your income, basic minimal income. And what is that minimal income? We need to, there is another question for that. You need to agree on that amount also beforehand, right? Sumit is saying, take out money from emergency fund, and amazing points. See, even if you are a student, you might have some income from somewhere already, right? Like maybe you did an internship, maybe your parents gave you something, maybe there is an asset, maybe you have a vehicle that you can sell off in the worst case, right? So that is sort of your emergency fund. I think very important point, Sumit. Thank you. Satyaprakash is saying, less money, survive, keep on my hope till I help myself back, get back. No money, start taking hardest routine I can, working on multiple possible firms irrespective of their work. Good point. Satyaprakash, good point, but your answer is slightly generic. Most of your answers, right? That hardest route, what is that? You need to try and agree on something right now. Good. Kuldeep, upgrade my skills. Freelancing. So I think some of you can freelance now also. Very good. Saurav, I'll try harder by upgrading my skills. Have connection, IT people. Awesome. I like to teach students and give tuitions and get some money. Awesome. I think at least we have all of us thought something, right? Awesome. Let's go to next question. How much money do you think you need? That was the first one. How much you want, right? This is how much you need, not want. How much money do you think you need in the first 3 years for a decent life? Not a luxurious life, but for an okay-ish life, what is your projection? How much money do you think you need? Any idea? Many of you actually don't have any clue, I know, because when I was a student, I had no clue. I was living in a hostel, my parents were paying for me, so I had no clue. But if you have no clue, that's also fine. But if you have some idea, think of it, right? 30K per month, I am assuming, Sumit. So per month or per annum, whatever you think, let's. Saurav is saying 4 LPA, okay. Sumit is saying 30K per month, okay. Anybody else? And again, a reminder, write down this question and write down your answer, because your answer will change afterwards. Might change, right? This is your first financial plan. Shine is saying 2 LPA. Good. I like Shine's answer the most until now. But others? How much money do you think you actually need in the first 3 years for a okay-ish life? Satyaprakash, 20K per month, okay. Thank you. Pratishruti, is there Pratishruti? You want 50K per month for a decent life? How much you need, not want, right? How much you need, like without it, you can't do. Pratishruti, it's not 50K per month. you need to plan for much lower. In fact, the lower the better. We'll come to that, but others. 100 into 30, no Gaurav, where 100 air rent also you have to pay, right? I think you're just accounting for food. Rent is a big thing. Who will, Sandeep Prakash Singh, 2.4 LPA, fine. What about others? 25K per month. Okay, thank you, Kuldeep. And note down your answers, guys, by the way, guys, right? It will change. It might change. It will likely change. Darshan is saying 15K per month. Okay. Anybody else? Okay. So my take on this is this. It should not be 15K also. Make it as less as possible. Right? Metro city lesser than 20K even will not work. Nahin, Saurav. So who is saying you that you have to stay in a metro city? And even in metro city, why can't you share with 6 folks? Right? I'm not talking about you want. Obviously, you don't want to live with 6 folks. Right? But you need, see, the advantage is this. If you calculate all the money, like on rent, I'll spend 5K or 6K. I'll manage, right? And on food, I'll spend, I don't know, 3K or 4K. And on miscellaneous, I'll spend 3K, 2K, like bare minimum. You know what will then happen? You'll say, I need only 15K per month. I'll manage. Then that enables you to do a lot of things. It enables you to take big risks. You are not afraid of smaller packages. You are not comparing to random people, right? You will be able to take big risks. One, two, you know exactly what you want, exactly what you need, right? So you, let's say you are planning for worst case, we talked about. Yeah, I want a loan. How much loan you want? You know exactly how much loan you want, right? So keep it as low as possible. I don't know. Pratishruti said that maybe she needs a larger amount. I don't know. Maybe she has her reasons, right? Maybe there is some health issue that for somebody that she needs to take care of. So everybody have their own reason. But the point that I'm trying to put across is try to make it as less as possible, because that's what you need, the bare minimum, right? Guys, am I making sense? Thank you, Saurav. Am I making sense? Or does anybody disagree with me? And feel free to, by the way, disagree. Making sense? Thank you, Sumit. Okay, so calculate and ask. I know that many of you don't have an idea. Ki in a metro city like Hyderabad or Calcutta, like right? So Saurav is saying, how much is the rent? You don't know. So go and understand, right? Next question. What will you do? Again, important question. What will you do if you get much more money than you expect? Note down the question and the answer. After 10 odd seconds, let's start responding in the chat box. What will you do if you get much more money than you expect? Satya Prakash is like already real estate magnate. Sumit has looks like a good plan. Save half and invest the other half of extra. Awesome. That's a good plan, definitely. And also exactly what will you invest in? I think that also needs deep thought over months and possibly years, right? Like simple ideas are like real estate, Satya Prakash said, or stock market. These are simple ideas. You can go and learn more. But then there are lots of other avenues of investing, right? In businesses, in startups, or in your family business, right? So think hard about what will you invest in. So guys, can I get here some other ideas also? What will you do if you get a lot more money than you expect? Because I'm not hearing the real answers, as in like what I did, for example. I'll tell you what I did, by the way, but I want to hear from you guys first. Most of us, by the way, have not thought deep about it. As a result, what happens is what happened with me. I'll tell you what happened with me. Start high school startup and invite friends. Okay. I can start an NGO. Okay. Awesome. Awesome. Practically speaking, I would travel. See, this is the real answer. Satyaprakash, this is the real answer. I will travel, right? Invite friend mates. Okay. Saurav is saying invest extra money, maybe in stocks. Okay. Okay. Saurav, actually this doesn't happen. Maybe I'm glad if you are like that disciplined to do that. Okay, so I'm assuming, guys, you have your answer in your mind at least. It is important. This question is very important because many of you will actually get much more money than you expect, right? Pratishruti is saying, fulfill my family desire, invest money in share market ready for self-pampering. Awesome. I think this is a very good plan, right? It's a very good plan, Pratishruti. So what I did, let's see what I did. So I saved for 2-3 years, first 2-3 years, right? I saved decently. I was saving at least 50%. That was my target. I was saving it. I was not getting a lot of money. I had joined Microsoft, but I wouldn't say I was getting a lot of money, right? So I was saving at least 50%. I was pampering, self-pampering with Shruti, traveling a lot and doing all that sort of thing, definitely enjoying meeting friends, all of that. Then I think one worthwhile investment that I made was I bought a piece of plot in Hyderabad. I think that was in like third year or so, right? That was my first major investment. But then again, was not like a very big plot or anything. That was one investment, and rest of the money, whatever I had saved, you know what I did with that? I actually spent it all in my marriage. So I married earlier, but what I did after 3-4 years was I basically spent all of that in my marriage. I don't know whether it's a good thing or bad thing, but that's what happened, right? And I had not planned much what to do with the money. I was just saving randomly. Like I had a goal, 50% save. And I got a chance to invest in some plot, I did. But the important point is that I had not planned. And what I don't want you guys to repeat that mistake. Plan for it. If you really want to spend like pamper and spend in your marriage or whatever big event, feel free to, but plan for it. Don't ad hoc spend it like me, right? It's important. Plan for it. Okay. Moving on to next question. Personal question. Feel free to not answer or feel free to answer. Don't want to answer. That's also fine. What I'm doing by asking you this question is forcing you to plan for it, right? You will see at the end when I share my tips, this is also important, right? Because this is important. Let's all accept it. So at what age do you plan to marry? I'm not going to remind you after 4 years. Hey, you had said me you'll in that age, why are you still bachelor, right? But I'm just forcing you to think. I mean, don't drive that thought away, right? It is important for your financial planning. At what age do you plan to marry? Can I see some answers, please? If anybody wants to share. 27, good. Any answer from anybody else? Good one, Kuldeep. Sumit, okay. Thank you. Anybody else who wants to share? Saurav is saying, I didn't get what should be the proper way to do with extra money. We'll come to that. Saurav will come to that. In the last section where I share my tips, right? I'll give some tips, but that's again my tip. You can definitely plan your way. I cannot plan for you, but I'll give some tips from my side, Saurav. 29, thank you. Saurav, Satyaprakash, good answer. Pratishruti is now politically correct here, okay. Okay, no, Pratishruti, what I would say is, in your mind, have one number so that you plan, right? You can plan properly. Moving on. At age 25, which is around let's say three years, right? Shahin is saying 25. Okay, thank you. So at around 25, what do you think your annual income will be? You had told previously. Thank you, Darshan. Appreciate it. Thank you, everybody. So note down that previous question and answer in your notepad as well, right? So at 25, what do you think your annual income will be? You had all noted down your starting income at 25, what do you think your annual income will be? Random guess. This is like just a projection, right? Your wish list maybe. So let's move it fast. Note down the question and answer and move it fast. Okay, Shaheen, good. Again, I'm trying to force you to think so that you can plan. Okay, Sumit. Sumit, your original answer was, I think, 18 or something, right? And this is 92. Yes, okay, okay, fine. Shaheen, awesome. Anybody else who wants to quickly? So note down the question, please. It is important. Because I am telling you one thing, your projection, most of your projections will be wrong. It might be wrong. At some point of time, it will definitely be wrong. Right? But you are still thinking of some realistic use case. Okay, so note it down in your notebook, note down at 25 what your annual income will be. Right? Satya Prakash, good. Whatever. Right? At age 30. Write down in your notebook and the question as well as an answer, and in the chat box if you want to share, go ahead and share. At age 30, I'm forcing you to project so that you can plan. For planning, you need some concrete number, right? The expected, worst, best case and worst case. But before best case, worst case, let's just think about our realistic projection so that we will plan accordingly, right? Okay, can I hear at age 30 from a few folks? I'll just move fast here. Yeah, awesome, good, Satya Prakash. Thank you, what else? Can I hear from a few other folks? Okay, I'm not seeing any answer. The reason could be that there is, you have no clue, or that because I want you to project and write it down in your notebook. Write it down. It's fine. Okay. Sumit, thank you. Anybody else who wants to share at age 30? I have a comment on Sumit's because I happen to notice his numbers. I have a comment on that one. I'll tell for all of you, not just to Sumit. Thank you, Saurabh. Anybody else? I think Saurabh is following the same trend. I'll have a comment there. Anybody else wants to share? At age 30, what do you think your income will be? Okay, so quick comment. Others, like just from Sumit's and Saurabh's numbers, but the comment is for everybody, right? In India, the inflation rate itself is 5 to 6%. So your income must increase at least 5 to 6%. If it is increasing 5 to 6%, that means it is fixed, it is remaining same. Right, Sumit, do you understand what I mean by that? That it has to increase much more if for you to actually effectively increase. Like in US, right, their inflation rate is like 2 to 3%. So there you will not expect a lot of increment. But in India, because the inflation itself is so much, right, you need, your salaries will increase actually much higher rate than you are currently projecting. I hope that gives you some data points, Sumit, Saurabh, everybody, right? Kuldeep, thank you. Right, so actually it will be much higher. That's because our India mein, our expense, rent hi badh jayega, so you need a much bigger income, right? So maybe a hint to you guys, keep plan for a little bit more income, right? The complex interest when you apply, right? So there, compound interest, right? So rate of interest put at least around 10%, at least. Okay, so it will be much higher number, Sumit, Saurabh. Okay. Again, quickly, I'll not spend much time here. 35, 40, 50, 60. 35, 40, 50, 60. Some numbers, whatever you think, right? Quickly, I'll maybe give 20 seconds for that. For everybody to note down their questions as well as answers, and then we'll move on to the next question, right? Project yourself. I don't know your numbers. Project yourself. Sumit, if you, I'm telling you that it's actually going to be much more, much, much more than that. If you just even follow the average path, let's say beginning from your number, right? For you specifically, I'm saying, if you begin at that number, wherever whatever number you quoted, and calculate compound interest at 10%, let's say on an average, it will be much more, because when you are 60, right, the rent of the flat itself will be like much, much higher. It will be much more. But your number is your number. Feel free to note it down for all your, like I said, right? Fine. Satyaprakash, 50. Whatever number. I know these are pure conjecture, but that's okay. At least have some conjecture rather than not even thinking about it, right? Awesome. Awesome. So we'll move on to the next question. Now, you have already answered this question, that what will you do if you are get more than an amount, this amount, right? I think you have some sort of answer, but note down this question, because throughout your career, there will be times when you will get more amount. So note down this question, and maybe you can most likely just repeat your previous answers, right? Like invest or donate or whatever you guys said. But note down this question. This is important. What will you do if you get more than, and what will you do if you get less than or no income? It is important that you note down the answer so that you plan for it. Okay, I'll give 10 seconds on this question. Just note down the question and your own answer, whatever that is. We'll move on to the next question, which is important. This is where my tips come in, right? So we'll spend maybe 10 odd minutes to share some tips with you. But I'm just showing the previous question here for 10 seconds. If any of those milestones, 35, 40, 45, 50, 60, right? They are not met, or you get less than that, or you get no income at any point of time, what will you do? Write in one, two words, answer. I have invested, I hope that I'll get from there. I will have my savings, at least this amount, or I will save in stocks, I will have some sort of, I don't know, debt investment or whatever your plans are, right? Yeah, sure. Okay, so moving on to, so this is what I claim from my experience and whatever I have seen of the world. I have some tips for you guys. And what I'll do is, as part of this, I'll give you some data points. I'll try to show you some patterns and show you some data points. And I'll give you some tips on top of that. But you are free to choose whether to take that tip or not. But data points are important. Once you get those data points, you can plan your financial future based on those data points. So what am I showing here, right? See, on the x-axis here, if you can see the x-axis, right? There is, I'm showing the age, your age. Okay. On y-axis, I'm showing the percentage of your income for investment. I'm not showing the amount. Amount could be more for somebody. Amount could be less for somebody, right? And that's fine. Amount could be zero for somebody. That's also fine. But I'm showing the percentage of income here. And I'm showing the age on x-axis. Okay. So we will have a detailed discussion on this chart. And I will give you some data points from which I want you to plan for those data points, right? So let's begin. Around 21, 22, the first, right? I am saying that around, at least, again, very ballpark number, it could be more, it could be less. For somebody who is getting 6 LPA, it could be, it could not be 7%, because most of his income itself will go in his daily expenses, right? But for somebody who has bagged a 15 LPA package, maybe he will get to save 90%, right? But so what I'm showing is your investable money, investable, as in whatever are your daily chores, that too you will spend. There is no question on that, right? You have to rent, you have to eat, you have to support your family in some expenses. So that you have to do. But notice that there is a peak from around age 21, 22 to around age, I would say 27, 27, 28, when you are planning to, let's say, getting married, right? So there is a peak. And what is that peak? That you have a huge percentage of your income that you can invest. And what do typically people do with this money? In my experience, some of my friends bought nice cars. Some of my friends, including me, spent a lot of it in our marriages. Some of us invested to some extent. Some of you spent it by partying, by enjoying. So the different ways to spend it. But notice the data point that there is a peak from 21, 22 till about 27, 28. The amount, right, still may not be big. The amount may be still, I don't know. For some, it might be 3-4 lakhs. For some other, it might be 10, 20 lakhs, right, in 4-5 years. For some, it might be a little more also, 30, 40, 50 lakhs also, right? But whatever the amount, notice that there is a peak. Like, you are getting a big percentage of your income that you can invest in something. So my tip is invest, plan this investment. If Satya Prakash is interested in real estate, plan that out. That in my next 3 years, I will invest 5 lakhs in real estate. You may still lose it because, like, I had invested in real estate. I don't consider that as a very good investment, frankly. But I learned something from that experience, right? So you will learn. You have nothing to lose, more or less, right? Don't spend all of it partying or I would say don't spend all of it traveling. Traveling you can do later, right? Traveling you can do later when you have a little bit more amount of money. But recognize the fact that there is a peak here. So plan for your investments. Very important. Most of your friends will not do that. Most of your friends will not do that. They will not save or invest. Save, definitely. Save a part of it, maybe 30% of this or 40 or 50, whatever your threshold is. But definitely, because this is a time where you have no liabilities, you can take big risks. So take that risk. This is the time that you will take that risk with your investment. So take that risk. So guys, any thoughts here? I'll stop here. I want to listen to your thoughts. What do you guys think on this? Do you agree with me? Do you think that's not correct? Or do you have anything to add on top of that? So what are some thoughts? Gaurav is saying, what is the source? I am the source of this graph. I created this graph today, earlier in the day. And this is not any, this is only from my experience, Gaurav. Darshan is saying, empty pocket is best teacher in life. True. Kuldeep is saying, as an undergrad student, how will you plan? It is very necessary to do it now. Yes, Kuldeep. It is very necessary to do it now. I think that is the important point. That you know that whatever amount, does not matter, small amount, big amount, you will have that peak in the first 4-5 years. You need to plan for that investment now, because you can't one day wake up and decide I'll invest in real estate. No, you need to do some research. You need to do some study for a few months, right? Or even a year. Only then you can go ahead and finally invest, because you have like 3 lakhs or 10 lakhs, right? You don't have infinite money. So with that amount, you have to do some research before you invest, right, Kuldeep? So you have to plan as an undergrad. I'm insisting that, okay? Sumit is, how to overcome social status traps like impressive prior? Yeah, you have to set expectations. You know that you have this much money, Sumit. Let's say you get 20 LP or let's say 30 LP you got. And next 3 years, let's say you get 30, 35, 40. You save 50% of it. 50% you spend traveling somewhere in foreign countries, right? So you have 15, almost 45 lakhs, let's assume. But for that 45 lakhs, it's very easy for you to go and buy that flashy car, right? House is still okay, sort of an investment, but or spend a lot of it in marriages or attending other traveling, right? So don't fall into that trap. It is very important. In fact, one of the objective of this session is that for to avoid falling in that trap for all you guys. It's very easy to spend the money if you have it, right? Don't spend that. Plan the investment. Super important. And recognize that there is going to be, it could dip, right? The percentage will dip after 25, 27, 28. It will dip. Remember that fact, right? So you have the ability to take risks. Take that risks. Okay. No, Sumit. From my experience, you will not feel isolated. You, for a moment, you might feel that's okay. But in the long run, you will not. In the long run, once you invest 30 lakhs in something, after 5 years, it becomes 1 crore. People will respect that fact, right? People will respect that fact. And remember that fact that you are also preparing for the worst case. You know why people mostly spend that money? Because they assume that worst case will never come, right? But what if the worst, you spent a lot in your marriage, and what if the worst case came in then? If there is a very big recession and you end up losing your job, not for the reason that you did not have any capability, but for the reason that your whole company got bankrupt. What will you do, right? So through this process, you are planning for your worst case. Okay, awesome. So guys, we'll take around 10 minutes more to close the session. Okay, awesome. Satyaprakash is saying, awesome. Thank you, Satyaprakash. Sure. And I can suggest real estate is good, like you think, right? So you should invest according to your research. You need to do some solid research before you invest. Kartikeya, should we plan for grabbing XYZ package or now without having even a clue what? Yes, Kartikeya, you should plan for your percentage. That's why I'm calling out percentage. And definitely plan for average case, worst case and best case. That's definitely fine. But I'm showing percentage here. I'm not even assuming your amount would be less or more. I hope that answers your question. Sumit, do you agree to some extent what I said in response to your question or your comment? Okay, so we are planning for the worst case. Most people don't accept that fact. Okay, now, so there might be a possible dip in your percentage because there will be some new liabilities, right? You will get married, maybe you will have kids after 3-4 years. So there will be a dip. Recognize that for that fact. You need to save for that. Now, you know what? What might still happen? Even though the percentage is reducing in this graph, the actual income might still increase. In fact, most likely it will. Most likely what will happen is that because your income will increase at a decent rate, the amount that you will have to invest will actually increase despite your liabilities. It will. But it might not, right? Who knows, maybe you found a startup, maybe you will change a job where the increment is not that much. Maybe you face some sort of situation. So all I am calling out is recognize the fact that between like around 30 to 35 odd, or maybe 30 to 33, you will have some new liabilities coming in your life. Plan for that. And after that, around 40, I'm showing another peak. Because whatever happens, 30 to 40, your income will grow more or less, right? On an average, it might still dip, but over 10 years, it will not hopefully dip all the time. So it will increase. So as it increases, but your liabilities will not increase at that rate. Liabilities will more or less be stable, right? Unless you give birth to one child every year, I hope you not do that. Your liabilities will not increase, right? So, but your income will. So what that will bring in is another peak, right? So I am in the middle of this peak. So I am investing. I'm also enjoying. I'm buying new cars, new flats. That's fine. But you will get the luxury of getting a little bit more amount to invest around 35, 40. You will get that. Most of you, right? You will get that. So you'll get an early peak. After that, around between 35 to 40 and afterwards, you will get. But then recognize that afterwards, around after 40, there could be another dip because of some liabilities, because of your parents, right? Who will get to a old age, assuming they're around 25 years, 26 years, 30 years older than you, or maybe a little more possibly. So you might have to take care of them. So there will be a liability there. Recognize that fact. But also if you have kids, right? So around that time, maybe they'll be going to college or some sort of high expense, like maybe marriages or whatever, right? So recognize that there could be a dip, possibly. There may not be a dip. Maybe even if the percentage dips, maybe your income is going to rise at such a rate that the amount that you get to invest will still be very high, right? That could, but plan for the dip, plan for the worst case, right? Then after that liability gets over, towards the fag end of your career, between 50 to 60, you should get another luxurious time from the perspective of investment, right? Because then your liabilities will most likely reduce, right? Once your kids, I know maybe you guys are feeling a little shy, yaar, he's talking about our kids, like maybe that's fine, but financially speaking, right? You'll get a third peak after that, right? And after that, your income, like there will be a, it will dip all of a sudden. After retirement, it might dip. I mean, if you have like really good investments which are giving returns, like really awesome returns, it may still not dip, but most likely it will dip. But you can ask your parents right now, or your parents, maybe grandparents, right? Their experience, in fact. But most likely it will dip. So you need to plan for all these things. You need to plan for peaks, because when I asked you a question, right, what will you do when you got more than that? So those are the answers to your peaks. You need to plan for your peaks with those, with your answers, and also plan for your dips. For some, the dips may be like what I have shown in the graph. For some, the dips might be much lower. Maybe somebody gets fired. Somebody's company goes bankrupt. Somebody founds a startup which goes bankrupt, right? So all those things are very possible, very likely. And it's okay, by the way. There is no problem, by the way. As long as you've planned for it. As long as you've planned for it. So it's important that you plan for it. So I think that's it from me, guys. This was our last session in this session and in this series. And I appreciate so many of, most of you, I think, are coming back to this session. Many of you, because we had so many other sessions at MFL, I guess a lot of people could not join this, the last two sessions, because I'm seeing that the participation in the last two sessions was very low, as opposed to all the other sessions, right, where 40, 50 and even 100 people were joining. But though I'm ending this series, because it's also a little bit tedious on my part to do this every Saturday, what I promise is I will come back soon with more webinars, maybe a little lesser cadence, maybe once a month or so. But I'm here. This is my passion, to share my knowledge and experience with you guys. So I will definitely keep hosting webinars with MFL, right? So that's it from me for today. Guys, any thoughts on today, or what, any questions? So I'm pasting the link of the whole channel. I mean, there is no way I can paste just my 10 videos. So I'm just pasting the link of my channel, but you can find my videos in that channel and feel free to browse through them. Thank you, Sumit. Appreciate it. Thank you, Karthikeya. Awesome. And I appreciate your feedback as well. Thank you, Satya Prakash. Appreciate it. Thank you, Saurav. And like I said, I have always said, if you are not connected with me on LinkedIn, definitely reach out to me. And any question that you might have around career, around investment, around learning, around computer science subjects, I will love to answer your questions around preparing for your placements, anything, right? Feel free to reach out to me. Thank you, Darshan. Any thoughts on today's session? What, maybe if I can ask you this way, right? What is that one thing that you, Satya Prakash, definitely reach out to me on LinkedIn. So if I were to ask you, right, what is that one thing that you are taking back from today's session? Can I hear back from all of you? What is that one thing that you're learning, taking back from today's session? Okay. Thank you, Sumit. Anybody else who wants to thank you, Sumit. Anybody else who wants to share what they learned today? Awesome. Yeah, Karthik, yeah, definitely. You should create your LinkedIn profile. When I was a student, I didn't. But now the times are different. You should be must. Satyaprakash is saying not very important point, Satyaprakash. Not to be overexcited about what you are earning, more or less. You just know that there is a peak. Less also invest, more also invest. Super important. Saurav is saying graph was very much practical. Implement. Yes, Saurav. Important. That if you know that there are some peaks and there are some troughs, right? So you plan for that. Don't be overexcited. Don't be sad also. If anybody didn't get placed, don't be sad. There is no point. As long as you know your need, you know that you know exactly this need and you're planning for your worst case. And worst case might come later in the life as well. In fact, most likely, you know what? It will come at least once in your lifetime. It will. Most likely. So be prepared mentally and financially for that. Tarun, plan for worst case situations when you're able to plan. Awesome. Good point, Tarun. When you're able to plan, you have the luxury. Plan then rather than planning later when the actual situation comes. Right? Good. Awesome. So guys, we will end the session here. And like I said, I will be hosting other webinars. The frequency will reduce slightly, but I will keep hosting the webinars. Right? I will come back. And connect with you guys, and I look forward to meeting again all of you. So we will do that, right? Darshan is saying not able to connect in LinkedIn. Why? Search Pramit Bhuyan. You should be able to get. Okay. So guys, we'll end this session here. Thank you for joining in. Thank you, Saurav. Appreciate it. And it's already past midnight and really appreciate you guys joining in today. Awesome. Thank you. Bye-bye, guys. Thank you, Tarun. Appreciate.
Thank you, sir. I hope all the people get the most out of this last session. So thank you, guys. Thank you for joining. Thank you for all your responses. It was really a lovely session, including 10 episodes, 10 different episodes. I have shared all the necessary link in the chat box. You can find the recording of all episodes in the YouTube channel as well of MFL Edu Club. So yeah, as stated by sir, you should prepare for the worst scenario because it is the least one which you will get in coming future. So on this note, I'm going to close this session in a minute. So if you guys have any question regarding anything, we will be keep hosting this kind of such session in coming future. So stay tuned till then. If you have any queries regarding anything, you can pin us, like we are there on all the social media as well. So yeah, you can reach out there. We also have the WhatsApp group. You can ask any of the admin running any sessions or anything which you are you have problem with. Yeah, thank you guys. Good night.